Assalamu alaikum and welcome to MicroFiqh. Today we'll be learning how to perform the funeral prayers, or Salatul Mayyit. Now here's why we're doing a video on funeral prayers. It's because everybody needs to know at least the minimum when it comes to the funeral prayers. If you are an imam, obviously you need to know how to perform it. If you are part of the congregation, you need to mention the takbirat and at least the minimum dhikr that are required for funeral prayers. Otherwise, it's not counted. The funeral prayer is an obligatory prayer. It must be performed. However, you don't have to have purity such as ablution or ghusl, and your clothes don't need to be pure. You can even pray with your shoes on. Even though they're all recommended, you don't actually have to have ablution or ghusl. The funeral prayer is a wajib kifa'i prayer. That means it is obligatory upon at least one Muslim to perform it upon the deceased Muslim. If one Muslim performs it, then the obligation is removed from the rest of us. However, it is recommended or mustahab to perform it in congregation. So who is it obligatory upon us to pray this prayer for? It is obligatory to pray upon all Muslims. If any Muslim dies, at least one person needs to perform this funeral prayer upon the deceased. Now here are some conditions to keep in mind before you start praying the funeral prayers. Number one, the funeral prayer needs to be performed after the preparation of the deceased for burial. Number two, you, the one who is performing the funeral prayer, need to be facing the Qibla, and you need to have the deceased in front of you, on their back with their head on your right hand side and their feet on your left. Number three, there should be no barrier between you and the deceased person. There should be no curtains, no walls. The coffin is fine, the kafan is fine, but nothing else. Unless, of course, you're in congregation when there are other people in front of you, that's fine. Number four, you need to be close enough to the body, not too far, so that it's apparent that you are praying for this deceased person. It is even recommended to stand so close that if the wind was to blow your clothes, it could touch the deceased. Number five, you should not be higher or lower than the deceased person. A little bit of variation is fine, but not too high, not too low. Number six, your intention needs to be in nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, qurbatan ila Allah ta'ala. Number seven, your intention should be to be praying for the deceased person, or for the deceased persons, or for whoever the imam is praying for. Number eight, you should also pray after seeking permission from the wali shar'i, the person who has guardianship over the deceased. And finally, while you're performing the prayers, you should be in a standing still position, and the prayers should be in succession, as we will explain later in this segment. So how do we perform the funeral prayers? There are two ways, the minimum and the more extended version. The first thing is, as a mustahab, you should be calling out as-salah three times. Now, here's the wajib part of the funeral prayer. There are five takbir and a dhikr in between each one. You would start the funeral prayer with your first takbir, Allahu Akbar. And then you would say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. You would then say your second takbir, Allahu Akbar. And then say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. You would then say the third takbir, Allahu Akbar. And then say after that, Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat. You would then move on to the fourth takbir, Allahu Akbar. And after that you would say, Allahumma aghfir li hadha al-mayyit, if the deceased is a brother. But if the deceased is a sister, you would say, Allahumma aghfir li hadhihi al-mayyita. And finally, your fifth takbir, Allahu Akbar. And that finishes off the funeral prayers. Now, there are other mustahabbat, but for the sake of keeping the video short, these are the wajibat that you need to know in performing the funeral prayer. This was MicroFiqh, giving you a little dose of fiqh wherever you are.